Hey guys, in this video, I'll share with you how to create a minimal bootable Windows PE media on a USB flash drive. This can later be used for fixing crashed systems. To do this, we'll first have to install Windows ADK, which is short for Assessment and Deployment Toolkit. We'll mostly just proceed with the default settings here. You may choose to opt in for sending usage data anonymously. I don't want to do that right now, so I'll choose no and click next. Typical license agreement. In the last step, you will see various options on the left. Make sure that Windows pre-installation environment is selected. Don't worry if you don't see the option here. I'll show you how to install it via an add-on later. Now, let's proceed with the installation. It requires admin privileges. This can take a while, so I'm going to fast forward it. Once done, you can close it. After installation, we will check if we have the tool we need to create the WinPE media. Let us launch the deployment and imaging tools environment. It is basically a command prompt window with various environment variables preset. The tool that we need is called CopyPE. Let us see if it is available. It seems to be present. If this doesn't show up for you, don't worry. We will install the WinPE add-on now, which should definitely provide this command for you. Let us proceed to download the WinPE add-on for Windows ADK. Again, we will simply proceed with the defaults here. Click Next. In the last section, you will see only one option on the left. Click on Install. Now this might take some time, so I'm going to fast forward it. Once done, click Close. Let us launch the Deployment and Imaging Tools environment again. Now, we will take a look at the various options the CopyPE command provides. Type it and hit Enter. Since I want to create a WinPE media for 64-bit systems, I'll need the AMD64 option. We can simply copy-paste the example command and change the drive letter to the one suitable for us. Select the text, right-click to copy. then right click to paste. This command is basically going to copy a pre-baked set of files and folders to the destination given as an argument. On this computer, I have the C partition where the OS is installed, the D partition, and the F partition denoting my USB flash drive. Although I can choose to set the destination in C, I don't want to clutter the files there, so I'll pick D. Replace it in the command and hit enter. You may still choose to proceed with C if you want. The copying process has finished. Let's take a look at the stuff which has been copied. Now let's take a look at the size of this folder. It is just 300 MB. Now, we wish to put this on the USB flash drive F and make it bootable. The command to create the WinPE media is simply make WinPE media. Let us look at its options. Since we are interested in having a bootable flash drive, we will need to choose the UFD option, which stands for USB flash drive. Again, the example is handy here. One can also create an ISO disk image if needed. Let us replace the command arguments to have the appropriate drive letters. Oops, looks like this requires more privileges. Let's exit out of this. Now, we will relaunch the environment as an administrator. Type the command again. Select, right click to copy, and right click to paste. I had copied the files to D drive and my flash drive is F. Make sure you have backed up the contents of the removable drive because this process requires us to reformat the drive. Proceed with caution. It has succeeded. Let us take a peek at what has been created. As you can notice, the drive letter for the F drive has been changed to WinPE. And the occupied size on the drive is just around 300 MB, similar to as we saw before. Now it's time to reboot the computer and boot from the removable media. We shall now boot from the attached USB device. These options might look different to you depending on your manufacturer. Once booted, you will be greeted by a command prompt window. Let's clear the screen. Now we will check for certain utilities which are most commonly required for recovery operations, starting with diskpart, which is useful for disk partitioning. It's present. Next up, DISM, which is useful for disk image creation and recovery. That's also present. Now let's check for BCD edit, which is useful for manipulating boot configuration data. That's also available. What about xcopy, which is useful for copying files and folders? That's also available. What about SFC? All internet forums buzz about this one. Yep, that's also available. And finally, let's check for bootrec. That's not available. Don't worry, I have another video which will cover how to add this to the WinPE media. Check out the video description below. That's all, folks.